Should we start? Please select your mobile phones at least first. Good evening all. Today, Honorable Election Commission of India has announced the schedule for the upcoming general election to Goa Legislative Assembly. As per the schedule, the date of notification is 21st of January 2022. The last day of filing nomination is 28th January 2022. Scrutiny of nominations would be on 29th January 2022. Last day of withdrawal of candidature is 31st January 2022. The date of poll would be 14th of February 2022 and the counting of vote would be March 10, 2022. Friends, as you know, we have published our electoral roll on 5th of January. As per the electoral roll, we are having 5,62,500 male voters, 5,93,960 female voters, and 4 third gender, which totals to 11,56,464 voters, and service voters are 298. We have done extensive reorganization of our polling stations in view of the COVID and high participation in state of Goa, which resulted in increase of 80 polling stations from 2017 general election. The today we have 1,722 polling stations, which makes average polling station wise average size of voter is 672, which is among the lowest in the country. And if you divide it by 40 assembly constituencies, so we are having average voter size per assembly constituency is 28,912. And the biggest assembly in terms of size of voter is Vasco da Gama, which is having 35,139. And the lowest number is with Mormugao, which is having 19,958. As you know, like the electoral roll for the any assembly constituency is frozen on the last day of nomination. So which is in our case is 28th of January 2022. And considering the time required for filing of claims and objections, so any form which is received up to 18th of January 2022 would be processed. That is after summary revision. If people are still filing, if still there are voter in any voter which are left, we are open our channels like voter helpline app or national voter service portal are open. Even they can contact their BLO or 1950 in case they are facing any difficulty. So then up to 18th of January opportunities are there. People can still file for inclusion of their names. Friends, in this election, our focus has been on maximum tagging of persons with disability. I am very happy to share that in this period of time, we have increased the number of persons with disability voters to 10,318. And let me tell you that we had the meeting with the major NGOs yesterday. We are still open to tagging and BLOs will be further making round and will be updating. So through this medium, I would like to request all the persons with disability voters to come forward, use the PWD app or contact your BLO and get tagged. Reason being that we are extending absentee voter facilities to PWD voters in addition to senior citizens and persons on emergency duty which will be duly notified. So we would like that every section of society must feel important stakeholder and must have participation in the upcoming election. And let me tell you the category wise, in North Goa, visually impaired is 468 voter, locomotor disabled is 1591 voter, hearing disabled is 441, others 2636, totaling 5136 in North Goa. Similarly, in South Goa, visually impaired is 440, locomotor disabled is 1906, hearing disabled is 547, others are 2289, the totaling 5182 in South Goa. And we are still hopeful that more people will come forward and tag themselves in our database as a PWD voters. Friends, this election, as you know, Honorable Election Commission of India has announced that up to 15th of January, no Padyatra, no Nukkad meeting or no any kind of meeting will be allowed. So we will be strictly monitoring the guidelines of revised guidelines issued by Election Commission by all the political parties and the candidates. And right now our teams are in places to enforce model code of conduct in the public places from the defacement point of view. I would like to request all the stakeholders that there is a Goa Public Defacement Act, Goa Prevention of Defacement of Property Act 1988, which is very strict. So now onwards, they should start adhering to it, and no public places should have any kind of defacement. And the provisions are very strict. It is in public domain. So with this forum, I would like to request all the stakeholders to ensure that they adhere to the law of the land. And let me tell you the defacement definition, which include impairing, interfering with the appearance or beauty, damaging, disfiguring, spoiling or injuring in any way whatsoever, and the word deface shall be construed accordingly. Property include any building, hut, monument, statue, water pipeline, public road, structure, wall including compound wall, tree, fence, post, pole or any other erection except at specified locations. And collectors are empowered to do it, remove it. We will be keeping the watchful eyes. Now coming to the enforcement part, we will be having two flying squad in every assembly constituency 24/7, and static surveillance team will be deployed at the designated locations. And now there is a C-Vigil app which is also included with the voter helpline app. So through these apps, citizens can report any kind of violations to the election authorities, and we will take action immediately within the time frame. So citizens must play an integrated role in the ensuring a level playing field in the upcoming election. One important feature of this election is going to be publicity of criminal antecedent by political parties and candidates. We have been briefing the political parties in our monthly meetings, and even yesterday we had a workshop with the political parties. We have explained them different provisions made by the Election Commission of India in compliance to direction of Honorable Supreme Court. So they have to publish their criminal antecedents in national newspaper as well as local vernacular newspaper, and which is clearly defined, which is called local vernacular newspaper. So already we will be notifying the newspapers eligible as per the Election Commission of India guideline where they have to publish. And candidates have been sensitized, and the time schedule is within first 4 days of withdrawal of nominations, between 5th and 8th day of withdrawal of nomination, from 9th day till last day of campaign. So within this campaigning period, they must inform the citizens about their criminal antecedents. Even Supreme Court has clearly said that, which have been emphasized by our Honorable Chief Election Commissioner during their visit to state of Goa, that political parties have to give the reasons also when they are selecting any candidate with the criminal cases. So we expect that all the candidates and political parties will abide by these guidelines, and we will have a further from the law and order point of view. We have been monitoring the law and order situation of the state with the state police nodal officer, and a master list of persons with repeat offenses have been prepared, and district magistrates and the SDMs have been directed to take immediate action depending on the severity under different provisions of the law, so that we should have a level playing field and people can vote without any fear or favor or inducement. Moreover, all the enforcement agencies are part of the election management now. So any kind of gift distribution or cash distribution will be under our scanner. Banks have been sensitized to report to any suspicious transactions. Income tax department investigation wing particularly, they have set up extensive teams here. So all these teams will be deployed from different departments like commercial taxes, like central GST, even RPF, CISF, all teams, Narcotics Control Bureau, Anti-Narcotics Cell of Goa Police. So these teams will ensure that no any kind of violation of Election Commission Expenditure Monitoring Guidelines takes place, and anywhere if any information comes, we will take immediate action. So I request the citizens that they should actively assist the election machinery in enforcement of the election expenditure monitoring and model code of conduct guidelines, and we will ensure that a level playing field is maintained. Thank you.
Transfer of votes are still available.
Pardon?
Transfer of
votes. Addition, not transfer.
Transfer from office.
So they can apply in Form 6. Still up to 18th of January, Form 6, whatever we receive, we will act upon it.
So, if it is a violation of model code of conduct, will you be taking a small order of commission or will you be waiting for a complaint to file?
See, if it is visible, because our teams will be moving around the state, 48 teams are there, 80 teams would be, flying squads are there. So, they will be moving in addition to the returning officer, sector officers, and other officers. Even observers will be there. So that way, suo moto action will be taken also, and if any citizen is having any information, they can pass it on to us either by phone, that is 1950, or by email of CEO office, or by using the CVigil app.
COVID ko dekhte hue kya precaution lene ja rahe?
See, COVID pe do cheeze hai. Ek to hai ki State Disaster Management Authority aur Health Department ka apna guideline, aur dusra hai Election Commission ka guideline. To dono ko maddenazar rakhte hue hum log daily monitor kar rahe hain. और जैसे अभी हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंट का गाइडलाइन आया है अबाउट द मीटिंग्स एंड साइजेस, दैट वी आर गोइंग टू इन्फोर्स, एंड देन इलेक्शन कमीशन का अभी गाइडलाइन है, इंस्ट्रक्शंस है, जैसे अप टू 15th ऑफ जनवरी नो मीटिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ पॉलिटिकल मीटिंग और रैली और नुक्कड़ सभा रोड शो. सो वट एवर गाइडलाइंस कम्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सिचुएशन, वी आर गोइंग टू इन्फोर्स इट वेरी स्ट्रिक्टली. वो तो इलेक्शन कमीशन जैसा डायरेक्शन देगा, और स्टेट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट अथॉरिटी अंडर डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट और हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंट अंडर द एपिडेमिक एक्ट, इफ दे इश्यू एनी डायरेक्शन, सो दैट विल बी इन्फोर्स्ड.
कितनी बड़ी मशीनरी आप इस्तेमाल करें, कितने लोग इस्तेमाल
करें? सी, इलेक्शन में जैसे अभी हमारे पास एक तो बड़ा होता है सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेज का, तो सेंट्रल फोर्सेज जो आती हैं वो इलेक्शन कमीशन डिसाइड करता है कितनी आएंगी, एंड दैट रिमेन्स आई वुड से कॉन्फिडेंशियल. So that is a big chunk. Second would be the polling officials. The now we are having 1722 polling stations. So you can very well see that there will be presiding officer, there will be polling officials, then there will be MTS staff, there is a BLO. The approximately around 20,000 officials we expect to be part of the election management process.
How many extra polling booths?
See, this time like from 17, we have added 80 more polling stations to bring down, because Goa, we are witnessing consistently very high participation from the citizen, and this time we are expecting even more. So that way, considering that high participation, we have reduced the average number of voters at the polling station by increasing the number to avoid crowding, to give voters a better facility.
Sir, election commissioner also said that 60% of the polling station will be abcasted.
No, ours will be 100%. Yes. देखिए, एक तो है क्या कि हम लोग अपनी स्वीप एक्टिविटी से, जैसे सोशल मीडिया हैंडल हो गया सीओ गोवा का, या हम लोग अलग अलग कॉन्टेस्ट कर रहे हैं, और हर रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर और दोनों डिस्ट्रिक्ट इलेक्शन ऑफिसर भी अपने अपनी तरफ से मोटिवेट कर रहे हैं वोटर्स को. तो हमारा प्रयास है कि वोटर्स इसमें ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा संख्या में आएँ, और मुझे जैसा फीडबैक मिल रहा है कि हम लोग इस बार पिछले वाले रिकॉर्ड को हम तोड़ेंगे. सी, गोवा थैंकफुली वी आर हैविंग double vaccination rate itself is 95%. Then we would request that people must come forward, those who are left out even from second dose, and if the time is mandatory gap between both doses are over, then they must come forward and get vaccinated, because it is for safety of everyone, including the near and dear one of the voter herself.
So what happens to the candidate if they did not submit their report?
See, here, like the it is this particular phenomena has come on the direction of Honorable Supreme Court. So then we are compiling the list of such people, such candidates who are not adhering to the guidelines of Honorable Supreme Court, and it will be reported to the Election Commission of India, because this is a matter where Supreme Court that Honorable Supreme Court itself is monitoring. See, it is the law of, it is the highest court of the country which is given direction. So they must adhere to, otherwise they have to wait for the action. Contempt of Supreme Court, and then they can, it is entirely in the domain of the Honorable Supreme Court of India.
Last several times, malfunction of the EVMs reported. So this time, not to repeat that
in any water that will happen. Our EVMs have been thoroughly, like first level checkings have been done. That too, this time Goa is again. Last time Goa in 17 election, Goa was the first state to use 100% VVPAT in all the assembly constituencies. So this time we are having pre-FLC even. So that way thorough checking have been done, and then political parties are sensitized, adequate training have been given to the polling officials on handling of EVM. So we don't expect any issue on the day of poll.
Sir, is there any order regarding linking of Aadhaar card with the election?
No, not so far. Once it comes, then we will see.
Cancellation of voting card, illegal voting card process is still on.
See, we have done enough sufficient cleaning through deduplication softwares, through photo similar entries. So right now our focus is only on adding the left out voters, because elections are very close, and any kind of absentee shifted ASD list we prepare in this period. So we will see what to do with them, because there is a clear cut guidelines on dealing with the ASD voters especially. The VLOs will be surveying the areas, their respective areas, and will be preparing the ASD list. But our focus right now is on addition of any left out voters. Pardon?
Political parties.
So that the political parties have to decide. So that we are continuously monitoring, but this is a confidential information, so it can't be shared. Basically.
Sir, you have said you have briefed some political parties. How many participated? All
there? They are coming. We are regularly getting requests from even registered party, those who are not recognized but registered. So that way, our office is welcome.
But have they participated? They responded to your call?
Yes, even yesterday a lot of participation was there. What is the meaning of all? That's ours is we invite the recognized parties and those registered party who want to attend to our meetings. So that way they are coming and attending our meetings.
Sir, any steps taken for to encourage first time voters?
Yes, first time voter they are through our ELCs, Electoral Literacy Club. They are very actively, very enthusiastically registered this time. And I could tell you that this time, first-time voters have been a very high number. That is 1.67% of our total the voter size, 18 to 19. And we are having 18-19 age group is 26,297, which is very high. And we expect very high participation from them. Already you must have seen that there is youth fest we had, and then we are more and more competition we are going to have to ensure that they remain committed to voting in an ethical and rational manner.
Sir, abhi political banner sab lagaya hai, aaj se usko remove karega
kya? Yes, aaj se uska hamari team mein lagi hui hai kaam pe. Aap jayenge to aap notice bhi kijiyega. Okay. And I request you to even let us know in case anywhere it is left out. 1950. That is our single number for any kind of electoral services, people are, citizens are free to call on this. Complaints also, and complaints can be filed even by email. And then CVZL app is there where live, you can take a live picture, we will get the geographical location and our teams will reach within designated time. With COVID, as I said, that there are two aspects. One is avoiding the crowding. We have increased the number of polling stations. For patients, though, then like there is a standard protocol is there. The medical officer has to certify, and then they will be given the, they will be designated absentee voters, and they can participate through postal ballot. Yes. Yes. Physically, only those who are, who don't have COVID, and on the day of polling, when they come to polling stations, their temperature is high, then we will give them, if the temperature remains high, that means suspected persons, we'll give them the PPE kit and then they can cast in a physical manner. But those who are under home quarantine or those who are in the hospital, so one the medical officer can give a certificate that this person is suffering from COVID, so we will issue them the postal ballot.
Sir, ऐसा कोई incident हुआ है कि सब मशीन में ईवीएम मशीन में स्लॉट्स लीकेज हो रहे हैं, उससे ज्यादा कैंडिडेट बढ़ गए?
नहीं, ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता, बिकॉज वी आर वेरी मेटिकुलस. This is called commissioning of machine, this process where the slots are put up. Goa has been, our officers have been very meticulous, and since it is commissioning and everything is done by the manufacturer themselves, they are from the reputed public sector undertakings, like Goa is going to have Bharat Electronics Limited M3 EVM machine. So that way we don't expect any such kind of thing.
No, I'm not asking that. For your 21st days.
How many candidates can be accommodated?
So maximum is, M3 machine can handle around 200. How many? 284 candidates it can handle. And this is an example that in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, a lot of people have this thing. Around 200 candidates have participated, and all have been, this is a case study even, that our EVMs have efficiently handled. So we are fully prepared, and elections will be on EVM.
Sir, so, कैसे watch करेगा कि अभी जो दो तो जो five people more में ऐसा बोल रहे campaigning और election commission को इतना capacity है तो देखने watch करेंगे?
देखिए, इसमें हमारे पास एक तो dedicated teams हमने लगा रखी है, इससे बताया flying squad है, वीडियो व्यूइंग टीम है, देन ऑब्जर्वर्स रहेंगे, रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर्स हैं. सो फर्स्ट इज लॉट ऑफ ऑफिसर्स आर देयर फ्रॉम इलेक्शन कमीशन, देन आवर सिटीजन्स एंड मीडिया, दे हैव टू प्ले वेरी मेजर रोल इन इंश्योरिंग दैट ऑल द गाइडलाइंस आर मेट. एंड अल्टीमेटली सी, कोविड सेफ्टी इज फॉर सेफ्टी ऑफ सिटीजन्स. वेन एनी वायलेशन ऑफ द गाइडलाइंस आर नोटिस्ड, it is a matter of public safety, so we are alert, and we request citizens also to be on alert, and they must tell us in case any violation is noted. Fake news pe hamara do strategy hai. Ek hai ki we have ran a campaign in the last election also. This election we are going to have a major campaign targeting fake news. That fortunately Goa is, I would say, one of the best state in terms of literacy, in terms of network, mobile usage. The people are very smart here. They know how to verify any information. I don't feel that people will be guided by fake news, but we will further be having a campaign targeting fake news, that is one. Second, if we notice any fake news or any kind of violations, then Honorable Election Commission of India has set a clear mechanism for removal of such post from the social media platforms, in addition to taking any legal action if it deems fit. But we are fully alert to counter any fake news or any kind of mischievous posts.
Sir, two flying squad in each constituency are enough?
Yes, if you see the average constituency size, we have our voter size or even area wise, the two are more than enough.
Okay, and how many members are there?
There is a magistrate, then support staff, and then police is there. And parallelly, even let me tell you that police teams will be there separately monitoring law and order. There will be central forces doing the combing operations. You will see marked change and you will see a visible enforcement in the coming days.
Code of conduct lagega to tourism industry pe restriction kaise rahenge, kitne baje tak
chalega? Nahi, tourism pe dekhiye, code of conduct jo hai wo hai general guideline hai. We don't do anything extra, but we just ensure that all the existing laws are followed. Tourism industry should not be any have any, I would say, impact of code of conduct, because the like excise law, it defines a timeline, noise pollution defines a timeline, so that way these all will be enforced effectively, because this law of land is there. No any new laws or directions are issued. Basically these are all reiterated and effective enforcement is there. Even people are also alive and they inform us about the violations and our teams go and check for violations.
Sir, liquor shops ka kuch time agar
restaurant restriction ek to hai ki like collectors will issue the orders, then wait for the order, that is one. Second, you must see the liquor license. What is the, if you see the permit, up to what time they are having the license to operate. So that is very clear.
Sir, this time, पहली बार इस old age जो motors हैं, उनको घर पे working करने का right दिया गया है, तो उन पर influence नहीं होगा?
नहीं, देखिए, इसके लिए जो हमारा absentee voters के लिए पूरा detail guideline बनाया हुआ election commission ने, और हमारी पोलिंग टीम जाएगी उनके लिए अलग से डेजिग्नेटेड पोलिंग टीम रहेगी, और जो कैंडिडेट्स उनको भी बताया जाएगा कि इस समय आपकी जो पोलिंग टीम है वो पहुंचेगी. इवन दे आर हैविंग राइट टू बी प्रेजेंट देयर, दैट इज वन. सेकंड, सीक्रेसी ऑफ वोटिंग इज अ फंडामेंटल पार्ट ऑफ इलेक्शन, तो दैट कांट बी वैलिडेटेड. तो दैट मीन्स द वोटर विल हैव कंप्लीट सीक्रेसी व्हेन दे आर कास्टिंग द वोट. इट इज देयर ड्यूटी ऑल्सो एंड द राइट ऑल्सो. And our teams will ensure that nobody violates the secrecy of the vote.
और ये voting ballot पे होगा?
Ballot पे. Absentee voters जितने हैं.
Sir, criminal उनका background है, उनको उनके बारे में information देने के लिए some practice work बोला गया है. लेकिन जिनके ऊपर already cases court में चल रहे हैं, ऐसे candidates हैं, तो उनके ऊपर क्या?
नहीं, तो उन्हीं के लिए है कि ऐसे candidates जिनका या तो conviction हो रखा है या cases चल रहे हैं, तो they are supposed to, they are mandated to publish their criminal antecedents
three times
during the period, and then political parties have to put it on their website along with the reason. There is a clear direction of Honorable Supreme Court of India which everyone must follow and have to follow.
Agar aisa nahi ho jata
to we will be sending report to Election Commission of India.
Uske upar action kya hoga,
dekha jayega.
Let
the time come, but we
are political parties only on website, not to be
website called. Social media, like there is a clear cut proper system is there, formats have been designed for sharing the information.
So you can tell us what is the concept of webcasting and how it
will
be useful?
See, webcasting is a process by which we monitor the polling process within the polling stations, so it helps in ensuring that the polling goes smoothly and nobody create any disturbance at the polling stations. And further, with the help of IIT Goa, they have developed a system on computer vision technology, and we have named it Election Eye. We will be deploying it for the first time, and through technology itself we will monitor if there is any crowding or not, and it will give us a real time alert. Already we had given a demonstration to Honorable Election Commission, that they have already also appreciated it. See, the BLOs, after once the list of the candidate is clear, then BLOs will give them form 12D, and those forms 12D which are received by the returning officer will be considered for those person. It is not mandatory for either senior citizens or person with disability to vote through postal ballot. They are most welcome to come to our polling stations. So these people, those voters who want to avail absentee voting facility, then teams will be sent to their place, their houses, along with the videographer to record the entire process, and candidates will be informed for the voting, and at the same time they will take back their postal ballot and it will be submitted to the returning officer. Yes, so like Honorable Commission has already said that this time we are increasing the all women managed polling stations from 40 to minimum 100. I am saying minimum 100. It depends on our actual number at the end of the day, how many officers are available. So minimum 100 polling stations we will have will be managed by the women officials, and then we are targeting minimum 5 polling stations to be managed by persons with disability officials, that is PWD officials, and they are very enthusiastic and very much coming forward to showcase to the world about their capability in managing elections.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.